Ladies and gentlemen, what's going on, you guys? This is Joseph Conlon coming to you with your NXT review on Thursday, October 15th, 2020. I think this is going to become a regular thing on the channel. When I just start playing music before reviews, I get the flow going. I get excited. I mean, I just don't want it to feel dead. But I'm going to get some music going. And before we talk anything NXT, I need song suggestions. So, you guys hear Man in the Box by Alice in Chains right now. If you have any song suggestions that I should play and you want to listen to, leave it in the comments down below or follow me on, DM me on Twitter, and I will play your song in one of the reviews in the coming weeks. But we're here to talk about NXT last night. Honestly, it was okay. It was a good show, but half the stuff I just didn't care about. We had Damian Priest versus Dexter Lumis for the NXT North American Championship, and I mean, the match was fine, but it was too early. They had a takeover match on NXT, and Dexter Lumis was the guy to defeat Damian Priest, and Priest, he beat him. And then we got Candice LeRae and Shotzi Blackheart with an opportunity to go to Halloween Havoc. Undisputed Era from Sony Larkin and Danny Burch, and so much more. And if you have not already, make sure you go check out my Monday Night Raw review, my top 10 AEW matches on Dynamite in the first year, and last night's AEW Dynamite review with Maddie Anderson of Top Rope Squishy. Shout out to her. I want to thank her for coming onto the channel last night. I'll just finish out this line right here and then we'll get started. Feed my eyes. There we go. We'll play it again at the end. But I love that song, man. Man in the Box. And again, if you guys have any song suggestions that you would want to hear here on the channel, leave it in the comments down below. Let's get started. This night, really not a lot of segments at all. Honestly, all the segments were matches. We got match after match after match. It started off with Undisputed Era versus Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch for the number one contenderships for the NXT Tag Team Championships. This was a very good match. If you guys don't remember, they had a classic. Excuse me. Oh, I knew that was coming. But these two teams had a classic in 2018 at NXT TakeOver Chicago. And that was an amazing tag team match to open up the show. This one was very good. Not as close as better as that one was. But this was a very good tag team match. And I think we all knew where this was going. Undisputed Era wants to fulfill the prophecy once again. And they got the win. And next week, they will challenge Breezango for the NXT Tag Team Championships. Good match. Pretty good match here. Next week, we're getting Undisputed Era and Breezango for the tag team titles. I think it should be good. I don't expect a title change, though. I'm going Breezango. And I think that... what's their name? I can't remember. Shit, I had it in mind. Legado del Fantasma, that's who it was. I think those guys, Wild and Raul Mendoza, they're going to be the ones to take the tag team titles off of Breezango, whether it's on NXT or on the next takeover. We'll just have to wait and see what happens with that situation. Then we got Jake Atlas versus Ashanti the Adamas, who I honestly had no idea who this dude was. And he just popped up on my television screen. I'm like, who the hell is this dude? Ashanti the Adamas. And then I realized this is the former Tehuti Miles. So I guess he got his name changed to Ashanti the Adamas. I'm sorry, folks. I don't watch 205 Live. That's a waste of time. I don't think anybody watches 205 Live. That show's irrelevant as it is. So, this match, though, I didn't care. I didn't care whatsoever. The Legado del Fantasma guys, they got involved. And as the piano goes off in the other room, I don't know what's going on in there, so ignore that. Legado del Fantasma guys, they got involved and they helped out Jake Atlas with the victory. Then Ashanti and Jake Atlas attacked Legado del Fantasma. And then out came Santos Escobar. And then out came Swerve Scott with three steel chairs, looking like a six-man tag in the near future, possibly at the Halloween Havoc show. We'll have to see what happens there. Johnny Gargano versus Austin Theory. Austin Theory requested this match against Gargano. Gargano won this match in 12 minutes. Pretty good match for what it was. Both guys are really good. Austin Theory, I don't even remember if Austin Theory has a win on NXT since he came back. Austin Theory, if you guys don't remember, I didn't remember for myself, but Austin Theory was involved in the speaking out movement. And that could be the reason why Theory has been buried. Not buried. I'm going to take that back. He hasn't been buried. He just hasn't won a match since his return. So that's the point I'm trying to get across here. Good match right here, but Johnny won the match. I expected Johnny to win the match, and we do see Johnny Gargano before the end of the show. We'll talk about that, why I don't like that. Then we got into a number one contendership match between Candice LeRae and Shotzi Blackheart, and the winner was going to go on and challenge Io Shirai for the NXT Women's Championship at Halloween Havoc. And I'm like, this is perfect. This is absolutely perfect right here. Shotzi Blackheart is the host of Halloween Havoc. She's the host of that show. She's going to beat Candice here. And she's going to go on to face Io Shirai for the Women's Championship at the show she is hosting. And I don't think she was going to win that match, but she was going to put on a very good performance. But that did not happen. That did not happen. This match right here, this match was awesome. This was honestly, it's debatable between this match and the Cody Orange Cassidy match for what was the match of the night last night on Wednesday night. I think you can make a debate for any match, for either of the two matches, but this match was really, really great stuff. These two women just were great together. They had great chemistry. They're two women that they go out there, they don't give a shit. They don't give a shit if they're sore after the match or they break a nail. These are two tough women that I legitimately respect. The finish was interesting. The finish was interesting. Candice was on the outside. Indy Hartwell was standing right behind her. And she hands Candice LeRae a pair of brass knuckles. So Candice takes the brass knuckles. She punches Shotzi Blackheart. She tries to hide it. She won the match. She doesn't let the referee raise the hand with the brass knucks. She goes back and she gives the brass knucks back to Indy Hartwell. So I guess we're getting a little bit of a, I guess you could call, alliance between Indy Hartwell and the Garganos. I don't know how long this is going to last for. I don't know where this is going. But, I mean, it could be interesting. Is Indy Hartwell going to help Candice win the NXT Women's Championship? I don't think she's going to win. She lost her match at TakeOver for the NXT Women's Championship. And now, I absolutely hate when I sneeze on camera. Sorry about that. So where was I? Oh, she lost that TakeOver. So I don't believe that. Why would there would be no point of her winning this match? If she's lost that TakeOver, that's it. She had her shot. She lost. I don't see her winning this match again. Then we got Aaliyah from the Robert Stone brand and Toni Storm. Toni Storm. It feels good to see Toni Storm back. She beat Aaliyah in 5 minutes. Now, I'm not really going to talk about the match here. The match was a squash. Basically, Toni Storm won in about 5 to 3 minutes. But Toni Storm, she's very popular. And she has a lot of fans. Like, a lot of fans. Like, there's a lot of people I know that... So, as the idiot that I am, the one video that I forgot to put my phone on, Do Not Disturb, someone literally called me in the middle of the film. So, I apologize for that. We were at Toni Storm. We were talking about, as I was saying, a lot of people love Toni Storm. And then she's very popular in the wrestling community. NXT is struggling in the ratings. I know they win in the 50-plus demo almost every week, but they really struggle in the 18 to 49 demographic for the males or the females. I think having Toni Storm on NXT could really bring that graphic up when, like, she's on television and people are watching AEW. They're going to switch over to NXT just to watch Toni Storm and what she's doing. So I wanted to bring that up. I thought that was a very interesting point that I could add to the review today. But let's just move on to the next match, which, I mean, I don't even want to really talk about. We had Imperium versus Drake Maverick and Killian Dane. And I'm absolutely sick of this group, of this tag team already, between Drake Maverick and Killian Dane. They're both irrelevant, so they put them together, and they try to make a version of Team Hell No, and it's failing miserably. I'm not enjoying it whatsoever. Imperium won this match. Killian Dane attacked Ever-Rise when they came out for some reason. And then he told Drake that no one touches you besides me. So I guess he's defending Drake Maverick. I could not give a shit about anything that Drake Maverick and Killian Dane are doing right now. This is probably going to lead them to being the tag team champions. They did it with Daniel Bryan and Kane, but that was good. What Daniel Bryan and Kane did was good. This is not good. This sucks. This is not NXT. This is main roster garbage. So we got a couple announcements for Halloween Havoc and next week's show. Next week we will see Undisputed Era, Bobby Fish and Roderick Strong versus Breezango for the NXT Tag Team Championships. Then in 2 weeks on Halloween Havoc, we will see Candice LeRae challenge Io Shirai for the NXT Women's Championship. We will see Johnny Gargano challenge Damian Priest for the NXT North American Championship. And we will see Raquel Gonzalez go one-on-one with Rhea Ripley. I'm going to talk more about the championship matches once I'm done talking about this match. We had Damian Priest versus Dexter Lumis for the NXT North America Championship. Dexter Lumis in August qualified to be a part of the North American title ladder match. He injured his ankle, so therefore they're giving him an opportunity for the North American title tonight against Damian Priest. Way too early, in my opinion. Way too early for this match to be happening. But the match was good. The match was very good, to be honest. I knew exactly where this was going, and that's exactly what happened. Cameron Grimes came in. He took the cave-in on Dexter Lumis. Damian Priest did not see this. Damian Priest hit a sidewalk choke slam to Lumis. That was the match. Priest saw Grimes, and then Priest gave Cameron Grimes a reckoning, and he was like, stay out of my business. Then Priest tells the cameraman to come follow him, because he wants him to see where he's going. He goes to the Titantron, he's about to do his pose. Then out from behind with a steel chair comes Johnny Gargano. Johnny Gargano comes with a steel chair. Candice LeRae comes out. They're both standing on top. And William Regal comes out. And he says, I bet you two are very happy right now. And they're very happy. They're smiling. He's like, Candice, you'll face Io Shirai for the NXT Women's Championship at Halloween Havoc. And Johnny, you will face Damian Priest for the NXT North American Championship at Halloween Havoc. But the stakes are even risen higher, as we have a concept made by the host of Halloween Havoc, Shotzi Blackheart. And she brings out Spin the Wheel, Make a Deal. So I'm guessing next week they're going to spin the wheel to see what stipulation both matches are. So we'll see what happens there. I don't like this at all. The matches at TakeOver were great. I don't like that we're getting this again. This feels so main rosterish to me. This feels like Monday Night Raw. Something that Raw or SmackDown would do. Like they've done Randy Orton, for example. They've done the Hurt Business versus Apollo Crews over and over again. I'm not saying it's that level bad, but, I mean, come on. Johnny just lost clean. He lost clean at TakeOver to Damian Priest. Yet here he is getting a rematch on free television. And then Candice, at least she won a number one contendership match. So I'll give her a pass. But Johnny Gargano, I'm not giving a pass. He's already had 3 North America title matches in this year. He's lost all 3 of them. So why would I want to see him get another shot at the North American Championship? So that's my thoughts on that. And ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up the NXT review here on the channel today. I want to thank each and every single one of you who tuned in to the review today. If you have not already, subscribe to the channel. We got some new subscribers to the channel. We've gained 6 subscribers this week. We gained 3 on Tuesday night, and we gained 3 last night for the AEW review. So I want to thank those who subscribe, and I hope you enjoy my content here on the Big Fight Field channel. Comment down below. I want to know what you guys thought of this week's episode of NXT. Overall, it was solid. It was a solid show, but not overly exciting. I think Halloween Havoc, though, I think that could be a really good show. So we'll see what happens there. If you like what I had to say in this review, hit that like button, man. Let's get this video to 15 likes. And then follow me on Twitter at Colin_Joseph. And turn on the bell for all notifications. I will see you guys tomorrow for your NFL Week 6 predictions here on the Big Fight Field channel, and then Saturday for the SmackDown review. Have a good night, guys, and stay safe.